Thank you, Chairman Smith and members of the subcommittee. Thank you for the invitation to testify today and for your leadership in the fight against modern slavery. More than 10 years ago, a group of women who had been enslaved in the commercial sex trade by the Cadena family in Florida testified before this committee. As a federal prosecutor, I brought over a dozen of their traffickers to justice. It was their courage that led the way to the path-breaking legislation that updated our anti-slavery laws and launched a new abolitionist movement. Looking back, we've seen the effects of this decade of development. Cases ranging from upstate New York to Georgia, from New Hampshire to Saipan. The TVPA has had dramatic results at the federal level, and state and territorial governments have followed. Just in the last few months, we've seen legislatures from Washington and Hawaii to Vermont and Tennessee becoming among the most recent to pass laws that track with the TVPA, and we hope soon that we'll see universal adoption of modern anti-trafficking laws in all of our states and territories. We've seen innovators, such as the witnesses that you've brought today, together for today's hearing. We've seen results from the federal government, and I'd offer for the record a document prepared earlier this spring by the cabinet-level task force about those activities. But even more, we see a movement that is maturing and expanding. With governmental leaders like Washington State Attorney General Rob McKenna, who next week, when he is sworn in as president of the National Association of Attorneys General, will make trafficking the flagship issue of his term. With civil society heroes like Rachel Lloyd, whose innovative methods at GEMS are helping girls on their journey out of modern slavery and back into society. With successes like the National Human Trafficking Resource Center, operated for HHS by the Polaris Project, which receives an ever-growing number of calls linking victims up with NGOs and law enforcement who can help them. With coalitions of NGOs and advocates, such as the Freedom Network, the New York State Anti-Trafficking Coalition, U.S. PACT, Demand Abolition, Attest, and more, who are working for real-world results rather than just symbolic gestures. And bloggers like Amanda Clower and Young B. Dale, who are using new media to inform, inspire, cajole, and change. Because in a decade of delivery, it is results that matter. The symbolic work has largely been done. The baseline work of definitions and concepts and laws and programs, that's been very much done, achieved consensus and stability. But around the world as well as at home, it is implementation and results that will make or break this movement in the next decade. Having worked on the original TVPA and subsequent reauthorizations, I know all too well that while nobody favors human trafficking, good people who care deeply sometimes disagree about how best to fight this crime. Mr. Chairman, you've worked to bring together those diverse voices and to ensure that the United States remains innovative and in the lead. Indeed, the careful balance that you struck in the 2008 reauthorization ensured that the United States definition of trafficking and the application of the minimum standards would continue to drive international norms. The vision of the TVPA and the carefully crafted compromises of the 2008 bill deserve the continued support of this body. I would like to take one note of personal privilege and urge this subcommittee and the full committee to continue one of the most important things that Congress can do, and that is to get out on the road and see these people for yourselves. Get out on the road and have your staff see these people. One of the things that made the 2008 bill reflect the reality on the ground, for instance, was a trip that Sherry Rickert from your staff, myself, and some others were able to take to Thailand and Cambodia, to go into the shelters, to go into the red light districts, to see human trafficking once and for all. And I think that that's something that, unfortunately, again, in this time of budget constraints, in this time when there's so much pressing work to do at home, we often don't remember that it's those trips, it's those experiences, it's holding the trafficking victims in your arms that informs what we then come back and do here in Congress or in the administration. And so I certainly would urge that kind of continued involvement on the part of the staff and members of the committee. The challenges facing the United States and governments around the world might not be, at this point, so much issues of creating new legislation as the often more difficult activities of implementation, political will, and resources. So in my written testimony, I've outlined more fully a range of promising practices and forward-looking innovations that will help governments live up to the commitments that they've made and shape the next 10 years as a decade of delivery. These are solutions that harness the power of the business community and the consumer, but also challenge them. Challenge them to know as much about their slavery footprint as they want to know about their carbon footprint, to advocate locally and nationally for a world without slavery, and to reject the culture of boys will be boys and choke off the demand for commercial sex and cheap goods that fuels this crime. But as important as innovation and partnership with civil societies are, it remains a core governmental responsibility to fight against modern slavery. And the best tool for assessing those efforts is and continues to be the annual Trafficking in Persons Report. Leaders in Africa, Latin America, and around the world have credited the report as a motivating factor for their actions as governments. As Congress considers reauthorizations, it is important that we maintain and strengthen this diagnostic and diplomatic tool. Because it's incumbent upon governments around the world to go farther than just acknowledging the problem exists and passing laws that criminalize all types of human trafficking. Moving forward, our measure of success, whether assessing foreign governments or our own, can no longer just be whether a government has enacted a law that looks good on paper, but rather, is that law implemented broadly and effectively? All governments can and must do more. If otherwise functioning legal systems aren't responding to the needs of trafficking victims, developed countries can't just stand by and presume that they're doing well. Developing countries can't absolve themselves of responsibility by pleading lack of capacity, because crimes are usually not solved with money, they're solved with political will and standards and high expectations for police, prosecutors, and judges. Governments shouldn't just aggressively pursue traffickers, they have to couple enforcement with robust victim identification and protection efforts and proactive attempts to prevent this crime. And they must affirmatively partner with NGOs. NGOs asking the government to act is not partnering. Working together is. We've come a long way in the last decade. Last week, an attorney for the women who testified here a decade ago joined me at a meeting of the U.S.-Russia Presidential Civil Society Working Group. She continues to represent those clients, but she also has become a global leader in victim rights advocacy, sharing the lessons that she has learned from them and dozens of subsequent clients. It struck me during those meetings last week that the lessons and examples of the Kalina case continue to inform how we fight this crime today. The strength of those women and girls and their success today, 10 years later, in having been reintegrated into our society as survivors, must continue to serve as a call to action for us to deliver on the uniquely American promise of freedom. We must continue to be a strong voice for those women, for other survivors, and the millions of victims who remain lost in the shadows, unable to break free or speak out. It is they who inspired a decade of development. It is us who owe them a decade of delivery. Thank you.